extraordinary session. Extraordinary session. We do have a regular rhythm of Toastmasters sessions. The agenda goes like this. We do have a prepared speech. We have three prepared speeches, and the Toastmasters members will come and then deliver the speech as mentioned by the Toastmasters International. Why I mentioned extraordinary? Because today we have an educational session. So that's the reason I mentioned the extraordinary session today. And the second agenda, we have an impromptu speech. It's nothing but a table topics wherein speakers and guests can come and speak for a minute of 1 to 2 minutes. This improves the on the fly, if you want to, if a topic is given, how you are good at. So that improves our impromptu speech. The final one is the general evaluation speech. So that's the beauty of Toastmasters, how it's like what went well, what didn't go well. We take the learnings and then try to implement. It's like kind of a PDCA cycle, plan, do, check and act. So this cycle goes every week after week in Toastmasters session. That's the beauty of Toastmasters. So I welcome you all for this, what get another wonderful session. Please feel relaxed and then enjoy the session. To further proceed, I selected this theme for today, the power of your subconscious mind. There are a lot of misconception about what is conscious mind and subconscious mind. I got inspiration from this book called The Power of Subconscious Mind, written by Joseph Murphy. I read this book in the year 2005. I just checked which year I read this. 2005 I read this book. I didn't remember anything in this book. But one illustration Dr. Joseph Murphy has given in this book, that is why I'm going to explain that as part of the session. So to proceed with the Toastmasters, I would like to call the general evaluator to introduce the team. She is having a set of team to run the session. She and I joined together editing Toastmasters, and she's playing this role. She has programmed the subconscious mind today in such a way that she is coming directly from college. She wanted to attend, yes, she could make it. That's the power of subconscious mind. If you are not clearly communicating that, whether to attend or not, that confusion if you had, you will not be able to accomplish. She had a clear communication that she has to attend, and she's directly come from college. She is a versatile dancer trying for more than 14 years, and she's doing her triple E, electricals and engineering from VIT, and she believes that mind itself wavering so much, so she's not make use of the subconscious mind, but she is already doing that. So please put your hands together and welcome Vashi.
Difficult role, because first time guests you'll be wondering what exactly the GE role is going to be. It's basically sitting there for 2 hours and simply sitting. For doing this sort difficult job, I have two teams to assist. One team is called the TAC team, who will be working along the entire meeting, and the other team is the evaluation team, which will all people will just come and evaluate the speeches and go. This is exactly the situation. Imagine when you are the supervisor of a company and you make all the workers do all the work for you, and the boss comes and asks who did this job. It was really impressive. The supervisor just come in front and says, "Sir, it was me." He will never say it was his team. Similarly, as a general evaluator, that's what I'm going to do. My team is going to do my entire work, but I'm just going to sit there and enjoy. So, but at least one part I can do is to introduce my team to you all. So today we have two new Toastmasters taking up their roles for the first time. We have Toastmaster Pranav as the timer. When I asked him about himself, he told he's a self-driven business development professional who loves to work at a high-pressure environment. Oh my God, seriously. The reason is even more interesting. It keeps him motivated. Whoa. When I asked him about subconscious mind, he said it makes him come back to what his comfort zone is, and whatever he has lost in past, he can rectify it in future and currently work on it also. I would request a timer to read out the rules.
Hello, good afternoon, fellow Toastmasters and guests. So, as a timer, I'll be helping the speakers practice expressing the thought within a specific time, be it prepared speeches, table topics, and speech evaluators as well. So, the green card is the qualifying time, the yellow card is the target time, and the red card is the maximum time, and you also have a 30-second kind of grace time. For a 5 to 7 minute prepared speeches, I'll show the green at 5 minutes, yellow at 6 minutes, red at 7 minutes. You should speak for a minimum of 4 minutes and 30 seconds to qualify. For the evaluators, the time is 2 to 3 minutes. The green card is shown at 2, yellow at 2 minutes 30 seconds and red card at 3 minutes. And you also have 30 seconds more. For table topics, each speaker is encouraged to speak for 1 to 2 minutes. The green card will be shown at 1 minute, yellow at 1 minute 30 seconds and red at 2 minutes. If you speak under time or over time by more than 30 seconds, you will be disqualified and are not eligible for awards. If you speak less than 1 minute also, you will be disqualified. I will report the qualifying times when called upon at the end of the meeting. Over to you, G.
Thank you, Dr. Today, this R-counter person, we just caught him the last minute. So he refused to give what exactly he thinks about the team. So anyways, I have to introduce the R-counter for today. It is our very own current VP membership of Medley Toastmasters. He is also the founder of Superposition Technologies Private Limited, and he is a passionate wildlife photographer. He has to maybe mention that, because every time he does a meeting, he will be always looking for photography and wildlife. So, Toastmaster John, please read out to you.
Thank you. Hello Toastmasters and welcome guests. My duty as the R-counter is to listen to the verbal distractions such as you know, and so, but, and other filler words or sounds. I will also keep track of the repeated words like the and I. Lastly, I will keep track of long passes when they are distracting. I will keep track of the speaking errors in writing for each speaker and give a report when called upon by the general evaluator. Thank you.
The last Toastmaster who is playing the role of grammarian today is Toastmaster Prashant. When I read his profile, he said business analysis at Standard Chartered Accountant Bank. His hobbies include table tennis, carom board and reading books. Business analyst, reading books. Such a nerd. His answer for the team was, subconscious mind is a subtle director for all your actions in everyday life. Imperfections stored in your subconscious mind play out every day. Can I have the grammarian to read out the rules?
Thank you, Shri. Good afternoon, guests and postmasters. As a grammarian, it's my responsibility to pay close attention to all speakers, listening carefully to their language usage. I will take note of any serious misuses of the English language as well as any good usage. As a grammarian, it's also my duty to introduce the word of the day. For today's meeting, the word of the day is alacrity, and the meaning of this word is brisk and cheerful readiness. So the synonyms for this word is eagerness or willingness or readiness. So it is both an emotional and a physical this meaning of this word, it's about an emotional and a physical reaction than of a person. And a simple usage of this word is she accepted the invitation with alacrity. Another usage would be he took up the new role with alacrity. And the grammar tip for today, like there's a typical phrase which people use, which is not correct. The phrase is, I can't able to do it. It should be, I can't do it. Like if you are not able to do a thing, I can't do it conveys the same message. Or even if you want to use the word able, you should use it as, I wasn't able to.
Once
the speeches are over, so I'll hand
it
back to the stage.
Thank you, Vashti. So, we have set the context now for the Toastmasters' regular rhythm. Now we have, coming back to a little bit on the power of your subconscious mind. Our brain is something like a hardware. Any hardware needs a software to function. So what is that software? That's a mind. The mind further divides into two. One is conscious, the other one is subconscious. I'll get into more details as we proceed. Let's get into the normal rhythm of the prepared speeches to begin with. So we, as I mentioned, we have our as part of the prepared speeches. So first, we are going to have an education session from Adi from Chennai Toastmasters Club. He is district champion for the humorous speech contest Ovation 2019. The list goes like this. And also a divisional level runner-up for the international speech contest, also evaluation contest, division level runner-up. And also he served as president and VPM in Chennai Toastmasters Club. Please put your hands together and welcome Adi from Toastmasters.
meeting for our meeting.
Once again, good evening.
Good evening.
I would like to start with a disclaimer. You know what session is this, right? Educational session about a humorous speech. How to deliver a humorous speech, how to write a humorous speech. The first disclaimer is, a educational session. So the disclaimer is, when you are listening to a humorous speech, you can expect the speech to be humorous. You can feel like this whenever you are looking for a good humorous speech. But when you are in an educational session about a humorous speech, you will definitely feel like this for the next 30 minutes. Can you bear with me? Can you get into your serious business?
Yeah.
How to deliver a humorous speech? So, the first condition, a humorous speech should be user-defined. We are tend to like add some joke on like which has two meanings, which hurts somebody. Jokes are always tend to hurt somebody, because my mother always say, when you are giving a speech, humorous speech in a hall where there are 100 audience, 99 people laugh at a joke and one gets hurt. That is not a good joke. That is not a humorous speech. So you should not hurt anyone, because we always tend to select a topic which affects, like, if you are going to speak on feminism, definitely it's going to affect anybody. If you're going to speak any topic on socio-politics, definitely you're going to affect somebody. So make sure you don't select any topic which can affect anybody or has two meanings or three meanings on it. So this is what the first condition is. We are going to speak about these three things in this 30-minute session. What is that? W-H-O. W is, what is a humorous speech? What to write in a humorous speech? And H is how to deliver a humorous speech. And what is O? Can anyone guess? Output. What else?
Organize.
What else? What can it be? Anything regarding to speech.
Ovation.
What else?
Outcome.
What else?
Observe.
Okay, let's keep that guessing. Okay, till the end. Just think about, I'll reveal the answer in between the session. I'll ask a question at the end. So let's see who listens to the session correctly. So now we are going into what is a humorous speech, or what to write in a humorous speech. So every humorous speech needs to have a plot. Same as international speech contest, humorous speech needs to have a plot, which has to be humorous. So the first thing in what is plot? Whenever you start writing a humorous speech, you will always feel this. Am I a humorous person? Should I be a humorous person to deliver a humorous speech? This is what happens in everyone's mind. But in Toastmaster humorous speech, you need not be a humorous person to deliver a humorous speech. If you want to be a stand-up comedian, yes, you have to be humorous. You have to be spontaneous in our comedies. But in a Toastmaster speech, you need not to be humorous at all. Because Toastmaster runs on a completely different factor where it also complies on an opening, a proper body of a speech, proper conclusion, which has to contain small bit of humor. So that is the only difference between a stand-up comedy and a Toastmaster speech. So you need not to be humorous at all. So then how to select a plot from our life? What happens is, your neighbor, your friends, your colleagues, fellow Toastmasters, the whole world will always be quibbling you know what? Whenever you share them some happy incidents, like last week when you went to your family to meet your friends, like family, so you come and share it with them, like I enjoyed a lot, they'll be like, what next? When you tell them, I got a promotion, what next? They'll not share that happiness. So when you tell a joke to them, they'll be like this, they'll give a reaction. So what? What is there for me? But at the same time, when you share a pain, a struggle which you have faced in your life, when you share that struggle, they'll be like this. So they'll feel so happy just because they get connected to that struggle. So if you share a struggle about a failure in exam, there'll be at least 5 or 10 who always already failed in the exam. They can easily connect to you. The same way, pick the pain points. What are the struggles you have faced in your life? What are the pains you have faced in your life? So how to find a pain point? These are some global pain points which all the contestants use in a contest. First thing is marriage. Everybody speaks about marriage so that people get easily connected. That is a struggle they have faced for the last like 5 years, 10 years, whatever it is. Some of the things are like promotion, appraisal meeting, or financial issues, mainly hair fall problem. A main problem for 90s kid or 2K kid is a hair fall problem, hair graying things. There are a lot. There are hundreds or 200s of struggles. Because when you try to look at happy moments in your life, it will be very hard to find. But you just try to look at the pain points, struggles you have faced. There will be a lot of struggles in your life to find a plot. So this is where you find a plot. First step to write a humorous speech is to find a plot. Now with this struggle. Being a VP education, being a Toastmaster, whatever it is. So find a pain point and make it as a plot. Now your plot is ready. A small baseline is ready. So what are the characters you're going to speak? Things. The next thing is conflict. So if your plot is very flat, it will not be very interesting, right? So what you have to do is you've got to add a conflict to it. What are the, like if you see in a movie, there will be protagonist and antagonist, right? Only the antagonist makes the protagonist stronger. If this character is made well, so what is this character? Who is this? Basha. Nobody says Rajinika. It's Basha, right? Who makes this character, Basha character stronger? Antony. Without the Antony, Basha is nothing. So this is how a conflict should be. When you make your conflicts more and more stronger, your main plot getting automatically stronger. So how many of you know this movie? Like how many of you like this movie, first of all? Panchatantra. This is one of the most humorous movies, right? I would say that. One of my lifetime favorite movie. So on the whole, these 5 characters in the movie always face some conflicts. It can be smaller conflict, bigger conflict. For the whole movie, there will be filled up conflicts. So that is where this movie won so many hearts. So that is how, when you set a plot, the next topic has to be conflict. You can always say, what if there is no conflict? So you have to exaggerate it and add it. Nobody knows what is the truth. So pick a situation, pick a bad situation, make it as worse as possible to add as a conflict. This is what stands for, a plot and a conflict. Now, a base character about your speech is ready. You have picked some, I have picked a plot called my exams, and the conflict is my teacher or my invigilator kind of thing. So when you come to OASIAN, the district conference, some of the veteran speakers spoke on the district stage. I can share you some speeches in there. One of the contestants spoke about, he wanted to marry a Toastmaster. That was his plot. He wanted to marry a Toastmaster, his plot. What would be the conflicts? So he always says in his speech, he said, whenever a male guest called, he was a VPM, whenever a male guest called and asked for address, he said, it's wrong number, please cut off. He always speak to a female guest. So this is what his conflict is. Who are the guests coming to the club? This is what the conflict is. In my speech, I spoke about my grandmother. My main speech was completely based out of grandmother. My conflict is with grandmother. So what is the conflict going on between myself and my grandmother? Her belief system was completely out of myself. So that was a conflict. So, as you know, all Upan sir, he spoke about his learnings in Toastmaster related to his profession. His conflict was his, maybe his patience or some of the things. So this is where we always set a plot and build a conflict, all the contestants. There was one female contestant from Sri Lanka. What she spoke was, she had a boyfriend and she was like a tomboy look. She looked like a guy. So her whole speech was going like this. What are the difficulties she faced? Because her look, even in her house, in her Aadhaar card, in the airport security, what are the things she has faced, struggle she has faced. So this is the plot, is like her look plot. Conflict is all the people around her. What are the people saying about her look? So this is what the plot and a conflict is. Now with this basic idea, you can make a draft for your speech. Like 400, 500 words of a speech for a humor speech. The main thing is how to deliver a speech. We all have a good writing skills. We write some one or two jokes, a good story, but how to deliver a winning humor speech? This is where we lack as a general Toastmaster one. So the first thing is twist. This is one of the proven technique for a humor speech. If you can work out on a twist in a speech, you will win so many hearts or even awards. One of the veteran Toastmasters has shared his story. Like he had a daughter who was studying in third standard. Her teacher called her for a parent-teachers meeting. He went with her for school. There are a lot of parents, kids are crowded. So teacher called this particular kid with her parent. He went and teacher said, your kid is very weak in studies. She don't even know some of the basic alphabets, some basic differences. Now what is the problem? She doesn't even know the difference between a cow and a buffalo. How can a teacher? She is in third standard. Now this Toastmaster got tensed. He got frustrated. What he did was he pulled that kid, started beating in front of the teacher. The teacher come in between and stuff, sir, don't hit her in school. Ma'am, you stay away, this is my family matter, I have to beat her. Again, he started beating. Continuously, when you're beating,